I thought they were all
over there. Number two, it's number one. Number two, it's number three.
They said it would take.
No, you're number two.
No,
Chris. They said it would take a miracle to bring back manufacturing. I brought back 700,000 jobs. They brought back nothing. They gave up on manufacturing.
Well, I'm not standing fair.
I'm the guy who brought back the manufacturing. We brought back. I was asked to bring back Chrysler and General Motors. We brought them back right here in the state of Ohio and Michigan.
Wow. What a glorious crap hole were we subjected to last night. It was intense, it was contentious, it was unpredictable, and it was everything we deserved plus more. Welcome back, beautiful and amazing human beings. This is Luke Radowski of WeAreChange.org. A lot to get into, especially after last night's aftermath of just pure political gold. And that's why in this video, we're going to expose some of the fake theories out there, provide you some important context to what happened, and then delve into an issue that actually Donald Trump and Joe Biden actually agree on, that is having severe, devastating effects on all of us, even though it's becoming way, way, way more confusing and complex to understand, as we have a new bombshell report from the New York Times that literally puts everything into question. And before we get into that plus a lot more, I wanted to remind everyone that last night we actually used our backup channel, News for Change, which by the way still accepts super chats and memberships, to do a full live stream and breakdown of everything that unfolded last night. If you're not subscribed to this channel, you should definitely click the link down below and maybe even click the bell button. And if you're lucky, you'll be able to see some of our live coverage, which I think we're going to be doing a lot more. Since, of course, we fully rely on your support and your donations to exist as an independent media organization, there's many ways you could support us on wearechange.org/donate, whether with physical mail, Venmo, Cash App, cryptocurrencies, PayPal, and even ways without spending a single dime, which actually also in many instances rewards you. So yeah, because of that amazing, incredible super chat feature that allows us to interact with you, we're definitely going to be doing more live streams on this backup channel, so stay tuned. Now, I think what happened last night is definitely best qualified in the memes that came after it. As of course, a lot of people were left kind of shocked, stunned, but definitely entertained from the events that unfolded during the first presidential debate of 2020. There are two more to go. Two more that, of course, we will be live streaming as well. And obviously, depending on what political side you choose to affiliate with, whatever echo chamber you are in, according to the algorithms, you're going to hear one side of the story while completely ignoring another. If you just read the Washington Post, well, you're just going to hear negative stories about Donald Trump. And obviously the same is true, especially if you're on right-wing websites. There's also this photo going around right now, allegedly showing Joe Biden using some kind of electronic device to cheat. And even though this photo shows something that looks like a microphone, it's actually his rosary beads that he usually wears around his left arm. And I mention this because even though we're swimming in an absolute sea of lies, the truth matters. Now, another focus of conversation after the debate was, of course, the performance of debate moderator Chris Wallace, which a lot of people are saying was actually carrying water for Joe Biden. There was a lot of loaded questions from Chris Wallace that many times seemed to be statements rather than actual questions. There was a lot of assertions heard during this debate, like the one that the Proud Boys were a, quote, white supremacist group, and that's clearly not the case here. Whether you like the Proud Boys or not, the truth matters here. And even CNN had to correct that statement and go on the record and say that the Proud Boys are not a white supremacist group, because they're not. There was a lot of focus on Donald Trump not condemning, quote, white supremacists. And it is important to note here that Donald Trump, many times throughout his political career, has denounced them, has condemned them, has publicly even disavowed them all the way back in the year 2000, and he has done so a lot of times throughout his career. A talking point which I think is very important during these very turbulent times. Now, Chris Wallace did press Donald Trump on his tax returns, while some people are saying that Joe Biden wasn't pressed at all.
during the debate. But I think it's definitely fair to say that Chris Wallace definitely didn't have an easy job at all, as of course the two candidates were speaking over each other, arguing, bickering, insulting each other, with Chris Wallace absolutely failing at gaining any form of control, which was a big aspect to how ridiculous this debate was, and also was why Joe Rogan was trending on Twitter during the debate, since many people said, we definitely need Joe Rogan to host these debates from now on. And I agree with them. There really isn't any kind of honor or dignity with the mainstream media. I mean, Donna Brazile, who was fired for rigging a previous presidential election, now is on Fox News on their debate panel. Now, as far as debate performances, there was a lot of talk about strategy, that Donald Trump was trying to get Joe Biden to disavow some of the far leftist ideas so he gets less support during the election. Others are saying that Biden had a better strategy. But in reality, I have to say, both candidates didn't perform that well. They all got caught in questions that they didn't answer correctly. There was lies from, of course, both candidates. A lot of interrupting and a lot of insults, of course. Many people accused Donald Trump of interrupting more, which I think is a fairly accurate thing to say. Some Trump supporters actually really like that. Others are saying that this was a negative thing, since many people who are moderate or in the middle don't see that as a good thing. A lot of people say Donald Trump was too focused on Joe Biden, who was looking into the camera and speaking more to the people, trying to convince them, rather than Donald Trump, who looked a lot more aggressive and, of course, combative. Now, also, there's a lot of focus right now about the Proud Boys and, of course, Antifa, which Joe Biden actually claimed is simply an idea and not an organization. Now, of course, that's one of the things that Joe Biden got fact-checked on. And even the New York Times decided to fact-check Joe Biden on many of his misstatements, and they're getting hell for it, which they shouldn't, because we should care about the truth more than we do politics. But that was a previous day and age. That doesn't exist now, and it's one of the factors to why we are headed towards a more chaotic and dangerous situation than ever before politically. And we definitely got confirmation about that, especially at the end of the debate, which only proved we're headed towards a very contentious election day. But very interestingly, the two candidates did agree on one thing, and that is the Conholio sickness jab. A jab that, of course, is unproven, rushed, and in some places might be forced onto individuals in some places in the world. There was even a statement by Donald Trump asking Biden if he doesn't trust Pfizer and other big pharma companies. And when we look at the records of big pharma, there's a lot of reasons to be skeptical, but not according to Donald Trump and Joe Biden, that are 100% behind this Bill Gates narrative, who is very happy that the United States is doing this. By the way, Bill Gates also recently came out and asserted that the United States had a horrible response to the Conholio sickness because, quote, we believe in freedom. In the same interview with The Economist from a Bilderberg member, a Miss Zaini Minton Bedos, a lady that we confronted at Bilderberg, by the way, in that same interview, Bill Gates, who of course gives her the time of day, said that in comparison, China had a great response to the Conholio sickness because they didn't have any freedom. And with the Conholio sickness, as the situation here becomes more complex, as allegedly cases keep rising and deaths keep going down, we are seeing some preliminary scientific data coming out showing that the viral load of patients with the Conholio sickness are slowly declining. But yet we're told in the media that the numbers are the highest in 6 weeks and that they're allegedly rising. All of this, as government officials are using this as an opportunity to flex their will and subjugate human beings by imposing draconian laws on them that they themselves don't follow. Just like U.S. Senator Dianne Feinstein, who was seen, of course, not wearing a mask, Fauci not wearing a mask, as other people literally end up in jail because of that. In New York, weddings are being broken up, place again where we're hearing that the numbers are spiking. New York, where of course many elderly patients were sent back to nursing homes when they were knowingly sick with the Conholio sickness, all under the orders of New York Governor Andrew Cuomo, who personally signed off on that order, causing, of course, chaos and more misery behind it. But yes, weddings, parties, all of that needs to stop. People need to go to jail for doing something the politicians aren't doing themselves. But, literally, protesting for Black Lives Matter, well, that actually... Now, this is not joking. This is an article by the IFLScience.com. It's a real article. I looked it up. That is making the arguments that specifically Black Lives Matter protests, quote, have actually reduced the Canholio sickness spread. Yes, that's the type of garbage nonsense promoted by the mainstream media. Literally, Babylon Bee, a satire website, released their own kind of guide for the Canholio sickness, which outlines a lot of the hypocrisy. And even though they're a satire website, their analysis of this is absolutely correct, as they themselves list many of the things that the mainstream media propagated, that it is unsafe to be inside churches, hugging grandma, sporting events, shopping, going to restaurants, getting your hair done, being at the beach, going to a funeral, being outside, voting in person, all extremely dangerous, according to the mainstream media and their hired guns, or also known as experts. But according to the mainstream media, it's absolutely safe to riot, to scream at grandma outside of a Trump rally, to have sporting events only with kneeling protesters, looting small businesses, being Nancy Pelosi at a salon, being locked inside of a nursing home in New York with other sick patients, harvesting mail-in ballots, staying inside and slipping into depression, voting for Joe Biden, and of course, letting Bill Gates inject you with the mark of the beast. And again, this is satire, and they're not that off. In even more ridiculous news, USA Today actually fact-checked the Babylon Bee, which is a satirical website. They literally state that they are fake news and that they're just here for the goofs. But according to USA Today, they are a legitimate news site. Again, it's absolutely ridiculous what's happening right now, especially with the mainstream media and especially with some of the new data coming in that potentially highlight massive inconsistencies with the official story. There is even a story by the New York Times that is suggesting that there is a massive majority number of false positives, specifically when it comes to these tests. And even the New York Times admitted that the tests are in question, which, again, we've been saying from the very beginning of this, saying that the tests shouldn't be trusted since, of course, many inanimate objects are coming back positives. Many people who weren't even tested are coming back positive with the, quote, Canholio sickness. And again, the massive levels of manipulation that we're seeing here should obviously be heavily questioned. There should be a lot of skepticism and a lot of mistrust of the official voices, since of course they gave us no reason not to trust them with their lies. Even Elon Musk, the guy who wants to put a microchip inside of your head, even Elon Musk is coming out calling Bill Gates a knucklehead, saying, of course, that he will not be taking the jab. And do you blame him? Do you blame any other rational human being who's actually paying attention to what's going on and seeing that what they're telling you is completely not true from the reality that we are all existing in? You're one of those human beings. What do you think? Let me know, of course, in the comment section below. I usually answer within the first hour. Check out our second backup channel. We're definitely going to be utilizing that as long as it's still there. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you, and this is why. Love you guys. Stay tuned for more here on WeAreChange.org.